Welcome back. We're continuing our conversation with Ernest Owens, the author of The Case for Cancel Culture, How This Democratic Tool Works to Liberate Us All. Ernest, welcome back to the show. So I always think that when you start to get backlash from very powerful or influential voices, it means that you're doing the right thing. And I couldn't help but notice that Elon Musk had a little bit of something to say about your book. You also had a very lively debate with Piers Morgan recently. I'm interested in what you think about any backlash to your book or this reaction. What do you think it reveals?
It reveals that the book is doing what it's supposed to do. You know, these are very powerful people. You know, Elon Musk is one of the richest people in the world. And the fact that he felt some type of way about my book that is basically trying to speak truth to power, I think the book is already, you know, fulfilling its destiny. It's manifesting in the way that I expected it to do, and even faster than I imagined. And, you know, for people like Piers Morgan, who has this big, huge platform that is, you know, in Great Britain and the United States, for him to feel some type of way about my book, which I reference him in the book, just shows that a hit dog will holler, and that these very privileged, powerful, rich white men are basically, you know, feeling some type of way that someone like myself is calling them out and demanding for them to be held accountable by the public.
Ernest, I wonder, just for you as a journalist, as a person, as a member of many groups who, you know, could be considered marginalized, so to speak, or targeted by the powerful, where do you tap into the courage to take sometimes unpopular positions or to challenge people who are in authority? How do you find that? How do you keep that going in the midst of, you know, others attacking you? It's something that I think is really remarkable and not always present sometimes when you're dealing with journalism that can be about access and trying to be friendly with everyone so you can get an interview. How do you keep that independent voice?
That's a really great question. And I think I've really leaned into just the purpose of what I do. You know, I have been in the game for 10 years. I've been doing this professionally, even in my college years. And when I look at my career, you know, I'm reminded by the people, the readers, the people who engage with my content, the everyday people who feel like the work that I'm doing is inspiring them, informing them, and empowering them. This is what this is about. Journalism is a public service. And so my service is serving the people and serving the communities. And so their validation, their input, their encouragement is what has kept me here and has elevated me over the years. You know, sometimes I think when journalists get in positions of influence, they forget that the people who read those articles, that watch those clips, that share that content are the people that are going to keep them fulfilled. I've never had to question, you know, my place in this industry, because I have consistently produced journalism that has made the people want to support me, whether I was at a free paper like Metro or whether I was writing op-eds for the New York Times or being on a show like theGrio. Throughout my entire career, I have always been supported by the people, big and small, famous or not famous, and that has been what's encouraged me to keep doing this work. So I encourage other journalists to remember that you're doing this work to inform the people and to the communities you serve. And if you do right by them, they're going to do right by you, no matter how hard it can get, no matter how difficult it can be.
Important principle to remember that that's who we serve as journalists. Final question for you, Ernest. Can you get uncanceled? If somebody wants to turn things around, what's the best way for them to get uncanceled?
A lot of people are uncanceled in society. In my book, I talk about how, you know, the world can change and people can evolve. You know, I think about Monica Lewinsky, who initially was totally canceled, you know, during the whole scandal and situation she had with former President Bill Clinton. Today, she is, you know, pretty much, I think, uncanceled. Many people see her in a different light, you know, changing minds, people evolve. And I think that in many ways, she's a perfect example of someone who's been quote unquote uncanceled. But I also say to those who feel like they are being canceled, take a step back and learn what caused you to be canceled in the first place. You know, do not gaslight, do not be super defensive, learn and evolve. And the interesting thing, specifically about Black people, we're a very forgiving people. We have a moment where we're upset, but we typically forgive. And I believe that can happen to anyone if they put in that work.
Humility is very key for anybody who's looking to evolve and move on to another level in their life. Ernest Owens, thank you so much for joining us today. Such a pleasure. And again, Ernest's book, The Case for Cancel Culture, How This Democratic Tool Works to Liberate Us All, you can buy that wherever you buy your books. Make sure you support Black-owned bookstores as well. Well, she paid the price and she paved the way for Black women journalists across the country. In honor of Women's History Month, we'll introduce you to Dorothy Butler Gilliam up next.